questions we need to be asking in relation to the death of Charlie last Friday is, will there be significant change within the Department of Child Protection, or will things just remain the same, as has always been the case, regardless of what the traumatic incident is that has happened, particularly the loss of the life of a child? Any loss is traumatic. Any loss is, if avoidable, is a sad event. It appears that this was, again, another avoidable issue. Now, governments change, ministers change, but the Chief Executive Officer, Cathy Taylor, has been there for a long time. And if anything, Cathy and those at the head of that department need to resign, because the system will not change until management has decided that they are not doing their job, until they can start to look at the work that they're doing to protect children and are actually protecting children, then nothing will ever, ever change. If you had at the head of an organisation a person who cannot see, will not see, refuses to identify the issues which have caused this department to over and over again suffer humiliating instances such as this one, then one wonders why you would keep that person in that position. If it was an organisation that had stakeholders, was earning heaps and heaps of money, losing lots and lots of dollars as a result of poor decisions made by its chief executive, that person would be kicked out by the board of directors. But in this case, no, Cathy Taylor remains. And I think it's sad that the government has decided to opt for those people who continually fail them in failing to develop a child protection system that actually helps families and saves children from death. Now, there have been some reports, and there are lots of attacks now coming out in the media and on social media in relation to the Department of Child Protection. It was inevitable. And it's not that I have some sympathy for the minister, because she's so new in the job. She hasn't inherited this problem. It has been there for decades. But the time has come now to do something about it. And we at the Child Protection Party, pardon me, have been urging the department to do something about these problems for years. We've known what they are. The public know what they are. Parents know what they are. They can tell you what they are. They can tell you about the interactions with staff, what that is like, and how unhelpful that is in having a working relationship that will enable them to have their child returned to them. They can tell you what the issues are, but the department refuses to listen. Absolutely, and it is so frustrating that we allow these situations to occur. So here is a family who desperately needed some help, and I've got a news item here from the Advertiser. And I just need to say that as we look through this news item, it is important that we understand that the Advertiser and other news medias look for the worst possible picture they can find in order to demonise the person in the midst of all of this. And in this case, they've chosen to choose a picture. It reminds me of the Tanya Staker picture back in the day when Tanya was pointing at a camera and looking extremely angry. It sells papers, maybe, and perhaps it helps people to look for a villain in the situation. The villain here is the department. So we need some really disgusting pictures of people like Cathy Taylor and other people in her department, because they are the ones that have caused this problem. And in this news article, they also show terrible condition of the home outside. I'm assuming inside was just as bad, but maybe not. But either way, the condition of this home would have been evident to anyone who had visited this child and this family that there were issues that need to be dealt with. Now, the title of grief of a lost mum, and certainly we must acknowledge that the grief that she must be feeling would be extreme. Friends rallied for Mother after Charlie's death, saying the DCP did nothing to support her. And this is the issue. This is, this department is supposed to be there to protect families and children. Now, years ago, I used to have 15, 20 years ago when I was working also with the department initially, they used to claim that the client, their client, was the child. Over the years, and they used to say, we always act to the best interest of the child. It was a mantra, and it was obviously appropriate way to be thinking. But in reality, the family is the client. So over time, instead of just focusing on what was well-being for the child, they also realized that focusing on what was the well-being for the family was a better alternative. And so they've chosen to do that because that is about the well-being of the child. You can support the family, the child can stay at home, doesn't have to be removed, therefore that is a better environment for the child. So they've changed their view around all of that. They don't say the mantra as much. They still do in some sense, but they don't say it as much as they used to. But unless you can find a way to work with the family, it will never, ever be a successful child protection system. Never. And in this case, it is obvious that they found a way not to work with the family. If one just has a look at the picture of the house outside, one would wonder, why wouldn't you send someone in to clean this up? Why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you find a way to demonstrate to this mother and this family that they can have a clean and tidy house, and that is a far better environment for them? And if they struggle with that, teach them how they can have that environment, you know? So why wouldn't you put the effort into any of that? Well, clearly the department didn't. As a result of their oversight, or their lack of oversight, whichever way you care to look at it, they failed. They failed miserably, this family. So the article goes on to say, neighbours who fought to save six-year-old Charlie's life in the minutes before her death have defended the girl's mother, saying she was failed by the state when she needed it most. So clearly, they knew that she needed help. The state refused to offer it. They simply refused to do it. Now, why did they do that? Who is responsible for making decisions to finally do nothing? They say the mother, Crystal Nyland, who was seen in public on Wednesday for the first time since Charlie's death in the early hours of Friday morning, was let down by the state when she needed help. Other sources told the Advertiser that Charlie, whose official cause of death was recorded as malnutrition, had been diagnosed with colic disease. Now, even though she had this chronic immune and digestive disorder, it's not like that's the excuse that we need to offer for this child's death. Clearly the disease could have been treated. The mother and the family could have been offered support around helping them deal with this disease in this child. It didn't have to end up and result in a child's death. Again, it is the system failing and letting down the child that is the primary issue here. The neighbour said they had spoken to Ms. Nyland, who was distraught. She watched her child die. Any mother who has gone through that would be traumatised and scared and confused and just heartbroken that her child, her baby, that she carried for 9 months is gone. It wasn't her, Charlie's mother. It was the state that failed. We're not blaming her for what happened to Charlie. She needed help, and DCP did nothing to support her in the way she needed help. DCP are at fault. They should have done something, and this is the consequence of their actions. And I think basically that says it all. The department is responsible. Someone within the department needs to now stand up and say, I am responsible for what happened to this child. We should have done more. There is nothing wrong with admitting that you failed. What they need to do once they've admitted that is how they're going to correct it so they will not fail other children and other families into the future. That is the key. Admit the mistake. We all should learn to do that, no matter who we are. You know, the department asks parents over and over again, to admit any mistakes that they have made. Over and over again, and they harp on it, and they harp on it. In this instance, the department needs to admit what mistakes they have made, what they have done to change this situation so that it is less likely to happen again. And one of those things is to get rid of the people at the top who continually support this dysfunctional system. I think that's vitally important. So I'm just going to read another article for you. And this is entitled "Closed, No Action: Why Child Protection Departments Stop Pursuing Some Cases." And they do. And there are some cases where there is no further way for them to go. They recognize in some cases that the parents are doing a fair job. So they stop some cases. But there are other reasons why they miss cases. And this is the issue. Not stopping action against parents and families because the parents and families have got their act together. It is also about, well, you know, maybe they overlook some as well. And why do they do that? Authorities will not say if any of the reports made about the welfare of a six-year-old girl who died of suspected neglect were closed without proper investigation. So they're not going to talk about that, of course, because that would be admitting fault, and why would you do that? People who knew Charlie and her Manapara family said they raised concerns with the Child Protection Department before her death last week. A government whistleblower also told the Advertiser there was 500 cases, and I talked about that yesterday. However, neither the Child Protection Department nor Child Protection Minister Catherine Hilliard would confirm whether any of the reports were closed without taking further action. Investigations by the Advertiser have previously revealed that about one third of reports of the department deemed to require investigation were instead closed. Often, and this is the point, often because of a lack of resources. And so there's two things, really, primarily that the department need to start to take notice of. Number one, have the people on the ground that can do the job. That's important. You know, if you've got notifications coming in, certainly visit the people, send them letters, get them to come into the office, do whatever you need to do to at least investigate those notifications. Number two, have the staff, and I reiterate this over and over again, have the staff that have the skill set to be able to find appropriate ways to work with families that are designed to help these families. Don't walk in, automatically remove a child, and then decide that you're going to work with the family. Find ways to work with the family. Find, you know, the best thing that anybody could do is let a parent know that they want to work with them and they don't want to remove their child long term. That is the best thing you can do for a parent. Now, some parents will take that up, do the right thing. In my opinion and my experience, normally that's the case. But for many parents, for some of them at least, they may not be able to do the things that are required, and there may be some limitations, and it might take a longer period of time for them to be able to make the changes required. Accept that. But, you know, so some parents do it in a short term, some parents might take a little bit longer. So be it. But the important thing is the relationship. So the relationship with the worker or workers is critical. But the problem they have is that there are so many of these workers who are inappropriate. So many of them don't have the skill set to be able to do what it is that they're required to do, that as a result of that, they fail. They fail the family. And as a result of their failures, children die. So something needs to be done in order to improve the way we work within the system. We will never get it perfect. It's impossible to say that there will never be another death, because there will be. But what we can do is put in place systems that are going to minimize that possibility. And incidents like this sadly indicate to us that the system fails. If you have a failing system and you don't fix it, it's just going to fail over and over again. So thanks everybody for being with me. Take care, look after yourselves. If you're watching any of this on YouTube, please subscribe to the channel on which you're watching it and make some comments below. Put some comments below as you're watching this on Facebook. I haven't done it live, but let's see the comments that you're making and share this as much as you can as well with those people who are on your Facebook or YouTube page. So thanks everybody for being with me. Take care, look after yourselves, and we will update this over time. Take care, bye.